Good morning, everyone. Hope you all safe with a good health. With you, Medina Badri, a physics teacher for grade 12. Let us start our revision sheet. Number one, give one word. This separation of white light into spectrum of color is called dispersion. Okay. Number two, the rate at which light strikes the surface is called luminous flux. Number three, the illuminance and distance will follow the law. The inverse square relation. The illuminance caused by a point light source is represented by E equal P divided 4 by R square. So the illuminance caused by the point light source is represented by E equal P divided 4 by R square. What is the unit of illumination? LX. The media which transmit light but don't permit object to be seen clearly. We call it translucent media. Number seven, media that transmit light, such as air and glass, are transparent media. Number eight, the illumination of a surface or the rate at which light strikes the surface is called illuminance. Red, green, and blue are each called primary color. We call it primary color. Number ten. Are two colors of light that can be combined to make white light. We call it complementary color. Okay. Number 11, a page mat that absorb only one primary color and reflect two from white light is called primary page mat. Number 12, what is the difference between the observed wavelength of light and the actual wavelength? We call this definition Doppler shift. What is the law of Doppler shift? Lambda observer minus lambda equal delta lambda. Plus or minus V divided C by lambda. This equation represents the Doppler shift. Okay, number 14. Secondary color that produce white light when added to primary color is the beige mint of the primary color. Yellow, cyan, and magenta, secondary color. Okay, let us solve chapter 17. Give one word. The shortest distance between point of a wave where the wave pattern repeated itself, we call it wavelength. A concave mirror produce what if the object is located between the mirror and the focal point? It forms visual image. The angle of incidence equals the angle of reflection in the law of reflection. So this is the meaning of the law of reflection. The point where incidence light ray that are parallel to the principal axis converge after reflecting from the mirror. We call this focal point. Number five, the amount that image is enlarged or reduced inside relative to the object, which is expressed by magnification M equal minus Q divided P equal high of the image divided high of the object. What is the relation between the center of curvature and the focal length of a concave mirror? C equal to F. Okay, number seven, a straight line perpendicular to the surface of the mirror that divided the mirror into two halves, we call it principal axis. Let us solve the problem, chapter 17. The frequency of the oxygen a spectral line if its wavelength is 530 nanometers. So lambda equals C divided F, and F equals we want to know the frequency. So F equals C divided lambda. So we find the C, the speed of light. So it will be 3 by 10 over 8 divided lambda 5.13 by 10 minus 7 meter to convert it from nanometer to meter. So the answer it will be 5.85 by 10 power 14 hertz. Okay, the second one, when I ask you a hydrogen atom in a galaxy moving with the speed of 6.55 by 10 over 6 meter per second, And the frequency is 6.16 by 10 over 14 hertz. What is the frequency of the light from the hydrogen atom would be observed? So he wants the frequency of observed. Okay, so we will use this law. We will use this law. Can you see? Yeah. V observers, F observers equal F. Multiply 1 minus V divided C. So the answer it will be 6.03 by 10 over 14 hertz. Okay. Let us solve number 16. So in number 16, he said that hydrogen atom in galaxy moving with the speed. The speed 6.55 by 10 power 16 meter per second away from the Earth emits light with a wavelength of 4.86 by 10 over minus 7 meter. What wavelength would be observed on Earth from the hydrogen atom? So the answer it will be here. Did you see? So lambda observer minus lambda equal plus V divided C lambda. So lambda observer is equal, yeah, lambda, huh? Multiply 1 plus V divided C. So the answer it will be 4.97 by 10 power minus 7 meter. Okay, number 3. The same idea here. He wants you, an astronomer is looking at the spectrum of a galaxy and find that it has an oxygen spectral line of 525 nanometer, while the lab value is measured at 513 nanometer. Calculate how fast the galaxy would be moving relative to the Earth. Okay, so lambda observer minus lambda equal plus or minus V divided C lambda. Okay, but he said that you can use the double shift equation. Okay, and the galaxy are moving away from each other, so use the positive formula of the double shift equation. Okay, so V equals C by lambda observers minus lambda divided lambda, and the answer it will be 7.02 by 10 over 6 meter per second. Okay, okay, let us solve this problem. Lamb is moved from 13 centimeter at 13 centimeter to 90 centimeter above the page of the book. Compare the illumination on the book before and after the lamb is moved. So E after divided E before. So we will write the law of illumination here and the law of illumination here after simplification. So D before square divided D after square, it will be 1/9. Okay, number 2, what is the illumination on a surface that is 0.3 meter below that emits luminous flux 2275 ln? So from the law of illumination, E equal B divided 4 pi V square, so it will be 2275 ln divided 4 pi multiplied 3 square, so it will be. So number 2, what is the illumination of a surface that is 3 meter below? So yeah, we say here E equal P divided 4 pi R square, so it will be 2 by 10 LX. Here in a public school, so here he said that in a public school law required a minimum illuminance of 160 LX at the surface of each student's desk. So what is the minimum luminous flux that the light must produce? E equal P divided 4 by D square, so the P equal 4 by E D square, so the answer it will be 8 by 10 over 3 LN. Okay, here he wants you to compare screen is placed between two lamps so that the illuminance that the screen equally. So the first lamp emits a luminous flux 1445 LM in a distance 2.5. from the screen. What is the distance of the second lamp from the screen if the luminous flask is 2375? Okay, so the answer here it will be E1 equal E2, so B1 divided D1 square equal B2 divided D2 square, so D2 equals 3.2 meter. Okay, let us finish. So this all the problem in chapter 16. Let us solve chapter 17 question. Okay, here he wants you to in a concave mirror had the focal length of 10 centimeters. What is the radius of curvature? R equal to F. So R equal 2 by 10 equal 20 centimeters. Okay. Number two, an object located 18 centimeters from a convex mirror produce a virtual image 9 centimeters from the mirror. What is the magnification of the image? So N equal minus D image divided the object, so it will be minus 9 because it's virtual image divided 18, it will be half. Okay, the second one, a boy is standing near a convex mirror in a fun house. He notes that his image appeared to be 0.60 meter tall. If the magnification of the mirror is 1/3, what is the boy's height? Okay, N equal high of the image divided high of the object. So high of the object, it will be 0.60 divided 1/3, it will be 1/8 meter. Okay, the last one here, a star image light from a star is collected by concave mirror. How far from the mirror is the image of the star if the radius of curvature is 150 centimeter? So he wants you to calculate the focal length. So from the law R equal to F, if equal R divided 2, 150 divided 2, it will be 75 centimeters. That's all. Hope you all understand. Thank you.